Well, I will try to finish because there are lots to talk about. So when I was not allowed to go into Syria, though my wife was waiting with her family to go inside and bring her back to Jordan, I tried to communicate with her. Can you believe it? I could not phone from Ramtha to Dera, Ramtha in Jordan and Dera in Syria. It's only about 2 miles away. I cannot call by phone because it has to go through the operator, and the operator will not take any calls from Jordan. So I have to call the United States, and the United States call her family in Dera that I was waiting outside in the part of Jordan. Horrible thing, you know. And so she came finally, and we arrived at the only hotel, 5 stars. It's called Continental. Now there are over 20 5 stars hotel in Amman, Jordan. And that night was a kind of a meeting, a reception for the delegation from North Dakota. And suddenly I presented to them my wife. I said, how? What do you mean? I said, I got married. This is traditionally, and there is nothing wrong. You find the wife, you discover her, doesn't have to have any kind of relationship before that. It works. Believe me, it worked. Because most important, really, the commitment. And to find a good lady, a good girl, who is dedicated to you and to your children. And that's when they mentioned those in their reports, they called North Dakota radio stations and other that Dr. Said got married. So everybody knew that I got married while I was there. From there, she went to Kuwait. We went to Kuwait and she waited for about maybe a month or so, and she came to North Dakota. It was Fargo, North Dakota, where we had our first child, Yasser, who is now finishing his residency in internal medicine and pediatrics in Chicago. And my Hashim, who finished at the UW political science, and he's now a famous personality in Al Jazeera, famous TV in Qatar. And my business daughter, I call her my princess, who is going to law school. And inshallah, since I was not born in the United States and I cannot run for president like Obama did, I try to urge her within 80 years or so to run, as will be the first female, especially a Muslim female, to see that Muslim are not coming out of space different. They are just your next neighbor. They think about how you think. They have the same thing. People have struggled for to live just like anybody else. This is the way. I would like to mention about when I took my kids for Disneyland sometime in the late 80s to go to California. And during the time I was there, news came back that my aunt, God bless her, died. I would like to mention that during the time I was here, she became blind gradually because of glaucoma, and they will tell her that, let's take you to the doctor. She said, no, I am waiting until my son, Dr. Muhammad, which means me, come back to cure me or to help me. And of course, she was at the time not in Kuwait, she was in Palestine, and because of boundaries, I could not make it to go to the Palestine and see her at that time. And she became blind, and she always told them that I was so far away that they separate us from, you know, separate me and her 7 oceans. She thought that there were 7 oceans. God bless her. And she, when she was in Kuwait, we were talking about visiting her, and with my children, we're so excited, you know, Then the news came back. She died. That was when we were in a trip to California. So I got with my children under a olive trees in northern of California, and we had prayed for her soul. And remember me quite a bit. I'm sorry for all of this. It's kind of emotional. And when she had a will that to take her to Palestine, put her bones or remains under a fig tree she planted almost 50 years earlier. And when I went with the physician for social responsibility in Seattle in 1993, and we visited the place that the fig tree where she wanted to be buried in our town of Burin, and this is mentioned in some of my website. Unfortunately, we have not been able to bring her remains. And of course, as a Muslim, I do believe that wherever she is buried, that would be okay. Though I would like to carry her remain when there is truly an independent state in Palestine for the Palestinians, or at least if there is a Palestinian state where Jews, Muslims, and Christians can live in a united, a secular country like ours in the United States, where Palestinians are having freedom and their human rights, and they are not pushed and treated that as a second or third class citizen. I will bring her remains, inshallah. At any rate, I would like to wrap up this, and hopefully I will say a few things in the future about highlighting some other important things which I did not mention. And with this, I conclude for the time being this personal biography about my life. And I will say, may God bless you, and thank you very much for listening and watching this recording. America, to be fair, an honest broker. We like America. We like to advance the interest of the United States. We are not asking them to support Pervez Musharraf or Hosni Mubarak. No, we ask them to be fair, to treat the Muslim with respect, to treat them as U.S. citizen, just equal like everybody else. And what's happening with the Jewish lobbies, with the Jews themselves, and the Zionists? They wanted the United States to be one-sided to Israel. So in my judgment, their interest more in Israel than the United States. So let's this difference explain to the American people. This way, I like you to get my message, get out, vote for me, inviting me, and I'll be available anytime, at any hour, to go and speak to you. Walhamdulillah, والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هذا الخطاب موجه إلى الإخوة الناطقين باللغة العربية. والحقيقة أنها لغة أحبها. لقد عشت في أمريكا 34 عاما، وكنت قبلها في كندا وقبلها في إسبانيا، أي أن حياتي أكثرها عشتها في الغرب، ومع ذلك لم أنسى هذه اللغة العظيمة، لغة القرآن الكريم، هذه اللغة المعجزة. ولذلك أنا أعتز باللغة العربية، وقد أرسلت لأول مرة لهذا الذي يسمى باليوتيوب، وكانت الفكرة من ابنتي العزيزة نور فلسطين، والتي هي